Are you here for so-called healing Chö? I said so-called because there's nobody to be healed and nothing to heal, or no healer and no activity of healing. We are in this together on this same journey, returning home, coming home, coming to the source of who and what we truly are. So basically, we just need to unveil it. We just need to let go of what's in the way of letting it manifest. Those people who want to lie down, today is all about replenishment, renewal, and returning home. So I want you to really give a gift to yourself for relaxation, letting go, and most importantly, letting go of the struggle against the difficulty, if you say, or whatever you don't feel comfortable. That's the beginning of healing, no? When we let go of the struggle, whatever circumstances you are in, then natural healing to emerge. So I don't want to talk too much about this. So now I want you to lie down. Those of you who would like to lie down, you are here for relaxing and receiving, so-called receiving. Again, there's no such a thing as receiving or sending. But then energetically speaking, when you are relaxing, you become more receptive. You become more open to whatever energy available. To facilitate that, if you like, I have some suggestions, a few options in terms of restorative posture. So if you have some prop or the blanket, I just gonna show you if you would like to lie down. Maybe once you lie down, maybe you might not be able to see us. That's okay. You don't need to see me doing this and that. And just you can maybe hear the my chanting as a blessing as well. This melody comes from awakened mind. It's coming from this spontaneous arousal of awakened beings' heart. So it has an uninterrupted blessing, stream of lineage blessing there. So you might steep yourself in that inspiration and grace, you can say, and whatever power comes from that. Okay, so this is the one suggestion. If you have a blanket, hold like this kind of long way, like this way, or roll up if you like. If you only one, just roll up like this, goes under your lumbar spine. My case, I like to put the two like this. Can you see? Like this way. Sacrum goes in here, just to the edge of the blanket, like this, for example. Like this. So your butt goes on lower or wherever you are lying down, like this. It's quite comfy this way. Your sacrum is supported, and your lower back is supported. Your mid back is supported. Then upper back is supported. Quite very supportive. Then, if you like, if you have a two blanket, even one blanket, see if you can tuck, hold a little bit under your neck like this. So neck is quite supported like this. This is quite comfy. Then neck, if you have another blanket or a bolster, my case, I have a bolster, put under your knees. So knees a little higher. So basically your feet flat on the floor, then knees a little kind of going like a backward V shape, then under your knee, some blanket or pillow or maybe bolster if you have. So like this. So the pelvis is low, like sinking into lake. I like this imagery. Your pelvis, lower belly is lower than heart, and also lower than knee. You can imagine your body is like a river, stream of river. Downstream, upstream. Then just take a moment to feel into this posture, whether you feel comfortable. You know, I should not be lying down, but then if you have like a eye pillow or something like that, to just can treat yourself. This is the time for you to, on behalf of all sentient beings, you do this replenishment. Then if you want to put something, like a sandbag or, you know, just blanket or something, that really calms down your nervous system, like this. So psoas is completely relaxed now. This is not time for really the activities. So just allow your body to relax. Tell your body, this is the time for renewal. This is the time for you to really relax, replenish. Then put some eye mask or something like that. Then if you like, you put your arms side of your body. And just I want you to relax. Feel into your body, this posture. We're going to go on a journey. Regardless, you are lying down, or are you going to perform Cho, this specific Cho called Ear Whisper Lineage, coming from the Awakened Masters, uninterrupted dream of blessing. Journey, this is a sacred journey, but going onto the Charnel Ground. You are on Charnel Ground. So what's your Charnel Ground? It's quite now easy to identify. Internal, external, and no border. So I'm just gonna dive into this journey. We're gonna walk together toward our own Charnel Ground. So those of you, if you like, feel into your body and feel into whatever, the activity, tension, stress, vulnerability, whatever you feel. See if you can gently breathe in, breathe out, so forth. All right. Most of the part we do in Tibetan, but some part I'd like to do in English. So I don't know, those of you who are new need to know what's going on, but basically we are going to the Charnel Ground, kind of specific way to go there. So we're going to chant those in English so you know what we are doing. Then once we arrive in the Charnel Ground here is a metaphor, the wherever fear-provoking place. Right now, we easily identify, no? And then internal Charnel Ground, your relationship to whatever happening, phenomena externally. So that might be one of the Charnel Ground. Okay, so then once you arrive at Charnel Ground, instead of running away, scared, we're going to invite more. We invite the entirety of the gods and demons, so-called. Your shadow part, you can say. Part of you which you didn't want to see, you didn't want to feel. Why don't you invite? Those are the part of you which need attention. Poor thing. So we go there courageously, and we carry the Prajnaparamita, the Great Mother, your divine presence, immense presence. Then we go on this journey, sacred journey. Start with refuge, bodhicitta, then offering and seven limb practice to make a relationship to divine presence, and so forth. Then finally, we come to the lineage master's prayers, lineage prayers. For that, we're going to encounter our lineage master face to face. At the end of the lineage prayers, that we're going to do so-called nectar flowing meditation. You will notice when we started to recite, so your body is completely purified. So those of you who are lying down, also, if you like, you can do, like that. This is universal, no? Seed syllable for complete relaxation, letting go, returning home. After that, we're going to go into this subtle body meditation, visualizing central channel and consciousness. Then slowly we're going to eject stage by stage with pe. Then last pe, we're going to eject our consciousness. We're going to let our awareness, consciousness separate from our old body, then merge into great expanse of totality, absolute reality. Then rest there. We might rest a little bit. Then as soon as our mind moved from that emptiness, as the expression of emptiness, compassionate expression of reality, emptiness, then all different activities arise or happens. Generosity of the offering of the body, chopping up your body and offer, so forth. Okay, then we're going to conclude with the Dharma offering. They still listen. There's carefully listening. After that, we're going to send off the spirits or the gods and demons, let them return to their home, and then meditating on emptiness of the three fields, giver, receiver, and the act of giving. All are empty of any solidified, projected identity, entity, essence. Then we're going to rest there a little while. Then the dedication. Okay, that's what we're going to do. It's about a little over 1 hour. So if you feel not so comfortable this posture, you can kind of switch around a little bit, whatever you feel comfortable. Yeah, this is your time. Thank you for coming. Thank you for taking care of yourself. It's immense, actually, for the benefit of all beings.